My scholarship ba sa AUP College of Medicine? Well, let's find out with me right now. What's up, future medical doctors? Dr. Martel Vicente here, providing you Med Remedy. Have you ever dreamed of wearing that white coat, but you don't have the financial capability of enrolling into medical school? Well, in this video, I will walk you through the scholarship grants available in AUP College of Medicine, the requirements associated with each scholarship, as well as its return service agreement. So keep watching and don't forget to check out my other videos if you haven't checked them, and don't forget to click that subscribe button if you haven't yet so you won't miss any upcoming videos. Now, what are the available scholarship grants in AUP College of Medicine? Well, AUP-COM have entrance scholarships, academic scholarships, sponsorships, and the DOH Doctor to the Barrio Scholarship Program. So what are the requirements? First, let's discuss the entrance scholarship. The entrance scholarship is divided into two. We have the full entrance scholarship and we have the partial entrance scholarship. Full scholarship entitles the awardee to free full tuition fees for the first year level, while partial entrance scholarship entitles the awardee to at least 50% or 25% tuition fee discount for the first year level. These scholarships are granted to deserving incoming freshmen who will be evaluated and ranked according to the following criteria. 1. We have the grade point average, the NMAT score. 3. The Latin honors garnered in their pre-medical or biomedical science course. 4. Outstanding Christian character and personal attribute characterizing the ideal future physician. Those who possess sense of altruism, accountability, responsibility, pursuit of excellence, sense of duty, servant leadership, honesty, integrity, and respect for others. Also, 5th is financial need. Now, if you're granted the entrance scholarship during the first year, in order to retain your scholarship in the succeeding years, you need to have the following. For full entrance scholarship, the awardee must have a weighted average or GPA of at least 91% to 93% or 3.5, and a no grade below B-, including the final grade of the semestral subjects and the mid-year grade of yearly subjects. For partial entrance scholarship, those who have been given 50% discount, in order to avail of the same 50% discount on tuition fees for the following year, the awardee must have a weighted average or GPA of at least 88% to 90% or a GPA of 3.25 and no grade below C+, including the final grades of the semestral subjects and the mid-year subjects. Those who were given the 25% partial entrance scholarship, in order to avail of the same discount, the awardee must have a weighted average or a GPA of at least 85% to 87% or 3.00 and no grade below C, including the final grades again of the semestral subjects and the mid-year subjects. Okay, so what if I'm not eligible for the entrance scholarship? No worries. All you have to do is do well on your first year, then apply for scholarship in the next or succeeding year. That is what we call the academic scholarship. Now, in order to be a 100% academic scholar, you have to have the following criteria. You should be Filipino with an outstanding Christian character and personal attributes, with a weighted average of at least 91 to 93% or a GPA of 3.50 in your first year level, and no grade lower than B- at the end of the academic year just completed. If you're aiming for a 50% academic scholarship, it requires that you should be a Filipino, again with outstanding Christian character and personal attributes, with a garnered weighted GPA of at least 88 to 90% or 3.25 in the first year level, and no grade lower than C+ at the end of the academic year just completed. So academic scholarships are just divided into 100% and then 50%. So if you want to avail those, do well on your first year level. Please be reminded that scholarships are considered a loan. If you are a scholar, you need to do a return service as part of your agreement. After completing your med school and you've qualified for medical practice by passing the physician licensure exam, the scholar will be obliged to pay his or her loans to the scholarship program of the university through a salaried employment in Adventist University of the Philippines, either as a faculty of the medical college or a medical staff of the university clinic. How long is the return service? Well, for every period of 2 years of service, for every year of full scholarship grant, 1 year of service for every year of 50% scholarship grant, and 6 months of service for every year of 25% scholarship grant. So, if you're a full scholar for the last 4 years, you need to serve for 8 years. If you're a 50% scholar, academic scholar or entrance scholar, you need to serve 4 years only. And if you are granted 25% scholarship, you only need to serve for at least 2 years. If the scholar is receiving scholarship from other institutions, AUP and the other institution can negotiate and agree on the schedule of the return service, because there are cases wherein the student is also sponsored by a hospital and then he or she is also eligible for 50 or 25% scholarship. It can happen, and those institutions can just agree on when will the scholar will do his or her return service. Now, what happens if the scholar is not able to pay the loan in the form of service in the specified amount of time and without prior acceptable agreement with the school authorities? Well, the scholar and his or her parents or guarantor are obliged to refund AUP or the sponsoring institution or hospital the total amount of loan enjoyed plus the interest set during the time of the non-payment of the loan. Question: what if I didn't meet the required GPA, academic grades, but I have the heart of service with outstanding character, personal attribute characterizing the ideal future position, with a sense of altruism, accountability, responsibility, sense of duty, servant leadership, honesty, integrity, and respect for others? Will I be eligible for scholarship? Sure ka ba dyan? Kasi baka mamaya after graduation, iwanan mo na kami. Well, AUP College of Medicine have sponsorships to those deserving students who have the heart of a 5-star plus physician. The dean, the academic council, even the academic coordinators, they arrange sponsorships from hospitals and specific training departments. All that is required of you, of course, is to do your residency in that specific hospital or specific training department that sponsored you. That's your return service. So how can you avail of these sponsorships? Well, to be honest, I'm not sponsored. I applied as an entrance scholar, and by God's grace, I was able to maintain it for the next 4 years. So I'll be teaching in AUP College of Medicine for 8 years. But if you want to be sponsored, my classmates, from what I know, they wrote a letter to the admin telling their concerns as well as what they can offer and what they would like to do in return. So yun yung ginawa nila. So just try to let the admin know. But also, apart from writing them a sincere letter and letting them know, you also have to do your best. Kasi syempre, it's sponsorship. Para naman ma-inspire yung taong mag-sponsor sa'yo. Diba? You also have to do your best. Even if the sponsorship doesn't have strict requirements as compared to the academic scholarships or entrance scholarships. Okay, so apart from sponsorships, you can also apply as a DOH scholar, known as the Doctor to the Barrio program. Yes, AUP College of Medicine is a DOH partner. So if you haven't heard about the DOH scholarship program, the DOH Medicine Scholarship Program includes the 4 years of medical education, including the summer immersion programs through second year and third year of medicine, as well as the 1 year postgraduate internship. So lahat yun, shoulder ng DOH Medicine Scholarship Program. In return, DOH scholars will be expected to work for 2 years in public health for every year of schooling as a DOH scholar. Okay, so what are the minimum qualifications for the DOH Medicine Scholarship? Well, number one, you have to be a natural-born Filipino or naturalized. Number two, you must have passed all the admission requirements, policies and standards of the chosen school, and other DOH requirements. So in our case, AUP College of Medicine, you must be of good moral character. And number four, the applicant must not have a scholarship grant or with an obligation of return service at the time of their application or at the same exact period. So my priority when it comes to the DOH scholarship program, who are the people who will be prioritized when it comes to the DOH scholarship application? Number one, applicants who belong to the minority sector. Number two, those who reside in indigenous communities and in JIDA which are certified and validated by government agencies. Number three, children and or dependents of soldiers and police who passed while on duty or fatally wounded and who have been victims of calamities. And number four, applicants who are government employee dependents, traditional birth attendants, and barangay health workers. If you belong to those communities or family groups, then you are highly prioritized for the DOH scholarship program. Now, what are the benefits of being a DOH scholar? The DOH shall grant to the scholar a package that includes the following. So we have the tuition fees, laboratory, miscellaneous, and other related school fees, which shall be paid directly to the school. Apart from that, the scholar will be receiving subsidy and allowances shown in the table, which shall be paid directly to the scholars. So, as you can see, guys, the table shows us what the DOH scholar package consists of. So, just refer to the table if you are interested in applying as a DOH medical scholar. So there you have it. We've just discussed the scholarship grants, the requirements associated with each scholarship, as well as its return service agreement. So ano pang inaantay nyo? Apply na sa AUP College of Medicine. The dream of being a medical doctor is within reach to those who are determined to reach for it. If you got questions or comments regarding specific segments in this video, don't be shy and comment it down below. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to click like, subscribe, and share with someone who needs to know about it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next week. Once again, I'm Delcy Martel Vicente, providing you Med Remedy.